Okay, here is the sketch that I did yesterday, and I've basically scanned it into Photoshop, and I've got let's see, I'll show you the base scan in Photoshop, which is that scanned in at 300 DPI and cropped a little bit. You can still see in the bottom. There's the sort of the curved edge of the moleskin book, and then I've added levels, which you can see there, to bring out the contrast. And then I've muted the color and the kind of over saturation there with a hue saturation layer, just pulling down saturation to minus 68. And then I've also changed the opacity of levels to 80%. And then I copied that group and merged it, so I've still got the original stuff there and ended up with that. And then created one fill layer, solid color fill layer, like so. Let's show you one as a demo. Chose one of the swatches that I've saved to try and keep things consistent down here. Green, grass green. And then selected the mask, the raster mask, the bitmap mask. And then just delete it. Delete the mask so basically sends it to the background color, which is black, so it's completely transparent. And then foreground color white, and then what I end up doing is, I'll just deselect that, is using a brush that I've got here that I've created. That's a mixture of different things. I'll show you the brush. F5 shortcut. So basically, this is the brush. I'm using a graphics tablet, a Wacom tablet, and if I press really lightly and then increasingly harder, this is what you'll get. Sometimes I like to add a bit of minimum diameter and punch that up a little bit so that it's not too thin, so I don't have to press too hard in order to get that width, because then you end up with a lot of patchy kind of areas that you have to keep going over. And then I've added a bit of jitter just to give it a bit more of a natural look. Okay, so you can see what that's like there. Just undo that. The other thing that I've done is then duplicated that layer, well, also set it to multiply so you can see the pencil through the colour. And then I duplicated that by just dragging it onto a new layer and duplicated it so it had six of those layers. And then they're all set up in the same way with a different swatch based on the swatches down here. Right, let's go on with it. So I'm quickly going to just paint this up. Zoom in for a bit of extra accuracy. Select the actual mask part of that layer. And then, as I said before, you're painting with a white brush. I like to quickly fill the whole thing in and then work back into it. I've also got an eraser set up that's very similar to the brush, but obviously working as an eraser. And I've made it slightly smaller because quite often the eraser I'll just use to just touch up mistakes where I've gone over the edge. I'm not too bothered about going over the edge here because I'm going to be working into that with a dark brown, and it's quite nice to have a bit of bleed. Just makes it feel a bit more natural in terms of how it's been painted. Because I'm trying to give that illusion of it actually being a watercolour painting to some extent, or kind of mix between a watercolour painting and a pencil drawing. So here's a good example where I can just use the eraser I've got set up by flipping the pen over. quite like working one colour at a time, just so you can see the progress that you're making with that colour, kind of stick to the similar kind of shading, I guess, that you've done with those elements on the drawing, so it all kind of gels together a bit better. Kind of works quite well to give the illusion of thatch, just doing sort of stripy, roughly stripy sort of layers to really build up that overlaid pattern that you often get on thatched houses. good tip is to try and really limit the palette that you're using overall, and to really just force yourself to use as few colours as possible. And then, if you really need, once you've kind of completed the bulk of the blocking in of colour, you can then introduce a new colour if you really need it, or if you really want to pick out a highlight or to emphasize an object to draw players or the observer's eye to that particular element. Otherwise, you can quickly get really murky, well, really confusing, and just like a rainbow, like a children's painting, I suppose, where they just really like to use every single colour, but in the end, you kind of end up with something that's doesn't really look planned. So start minimal, and then gradually build up more colour where you need. That's the way I do it anyway. Quite like to keep the rocks and the landscape elements one particular brown colour, and then just use different tones. And then use a different colour, a different brown for the trees and wooden bits, just so it's easy to kind of spot, subconsciously spot which is which when you're scanning the picture. These bits above here with the stones, they're kind of new style of terrain that we've been looking at. And so I think I'm going to explore that a bit more on other on new upcoming sketches. And I'm trying to work out whether they warrant a different colour. I might look at using blue for that. Or possibly, maybe we can just use the brown, see what it looks like brown. Also found that using this dark brown, kind of greyish dark brown, at this opacity level anyway, it's quite good for duplicating the layer, and then using one for colouring in areas, and then use the other layer for shadows across the entire drawing. Or to just kind of bump up the 3D effect. I might just try and do it all in one layer to keep things simple first. Just using the square brackets keys to take the brush size down a little bit so don't get too much bleed, because sometimes it can make the edge of everything look really soft and fuzzy. It's good to mix that up a little bit. when you're painting, the finished drawing start spotting a few areas where maybe it could do with an extra shadow. So it's a really good opportunity to catch up on those little bits that have been missed, because it can really make quite a big difference to the overall effect that you're going for. It's a little bit easier actually to do nice smooth shading. So the combination between having pencil shading and this kind of smoothish watercolour style, quite a nice complementary approach. Get some blue in. Just a very slight glimmer. to help sell the idea that these are glass panels. Not sure about the red there, to be honest. Benefit of having layers. Just like that. Let's see what this green looks like down here. Can try it out. Convinced. I think I might just change that to a different colour. Can experiment with it in a second. Might actually just work as a kind of grey colour. Let's have a look what it looks like. Think that's quite good, actually. Kind of like a dark green verging to. Into turquoise fat. I wonder if we just use, you know what, let's just use that swatch, then we're sticking to the rule of keeping the colours down to a minimum. we're pretty much done here, so let's just take one last final look. Call it a day for now. There we go. Hope you enjoyed that. See you again soon.